Philippine officials debunk China's claim of a supposed new model to manage their maritime row in the West Philippine Sea. A Philippine military official who allegedly agreed to the deal abruptly went on leave. Bianca Dava has tonight's top story.
The Department of Foreign Affairs stresses that only the President of the Republic of the Philippines can approve or authorize agreements entered into with the Philippine government on matters pertaining to the West Philippine Sea and South China Sea. The DFA asserts no cabinet-level official of the Marcos administration has agreed to any Chinese proposal pertaining to Ayungin Shoal, contrary to the claims of the Chinese embassy. The armed forces of the Philippines also denies that the Western Command was involved in any agreement with China regarding a supposed new model for the conduct in Ayungin Shoal.
It's not surprising that the AFP will be dragged into this, but we are one, all of us, kahit sino naman ang tanungin nyo, nobody is really saying that there is actual truth to this. So it doesn't even merit response from our end.
Any issue about
Meanwhile, the National Security Council dismisses China's claims as another page in Beijing's disinformation playbook.
The more that we comment on something that is not true, the more that the story gets extended. We're not going to fall into this trap anymore. Any issue about a new model is a dead issue to us after this.
NSC Assistant Director General Jonathan Malaya also assures the public the resupply missions to the BRP Sierra Madre will continue despite China's latest water cannon attack. Among the possible changes being considered is airlifting relief supplies.
There is a operational mix that is available to us. We can do other types of resupply other than a naval resupply. We can do an airdrop. We can do other just to be able to resupply our troops and keep BRP Sierra Madre in working condition.
Malaya also asserts the government has no plan to move the BRP Sierra Madre.
BRP Sierra Madre is not going anywhere. If the Chinese think that it's going to fade into the sea anytime soon, no, it's not. It is being maintained by the Philippine government. It is our military installation to ensure that Ayungin Shoal continues to be an occupied feature of the Philippines.
But another ship that is now the focus of the military is the decommissioned Navy replenishment tanker, BRP Lake Caliraya, which will be used for target practice during the Balikatan exercise between the Philippines and the United States. On Tuesday afternoon, the BRP Lake Caliraya was being towed to its final destination off the coast of Ilocos Norte. Formerly known as MT Lapu-Lapu, the made-in-China vessel was donated by the Philippine National Oil Company to the Philippine Navy in 2014. It was decommissioned in 2020. The AFP reiterated that the selection of the Chinese-made oil tanker as a mock target in the drills was just coincidental.
There's really no correlation as to the source of this ship. We take into perspective kung ano po yung assets na pwede natin gamitin for these exercises. So, it's pure coincidental, but it's really not directed towards the purpose and the source of such assets. This has been used by the Navy for so long. It was commissioned by the Philippine Navy and already decommissioned.
Bianca Dava, ABS-CBN News, Lawag City, Ilocos Norte.